we put together a number of task forces with the Biden campaign. One of them was on health camp. He, in fact, moved a whole lot, many areas. He proposes to lower the eligibility age for Medicare from 65 down to 60. Strong language on lowering prescription drug costs, doubling funding for community health centers, very important issue because we're very weak in terms of primary health care. I'll let you ask Joe Biden that as to why he is not a supporter of Medicare for all. He is not.
AOC is brilliant, and the other three women we're talking about are really smart.
To get our people to work and our kids to school safely, to get our kids to market swiftly, to power a clean energy revolution in this country, we need to modernize America's infrastructure.
What about taxes? What about your wallet? Well, a repeal of the Trump tax cuts and a higher federal minimum wage that would slam businesses. Look at what the Tax Foundation estimates, that Biden's policies will slash 585,000 full-time jobs.
I'm the guy that has responsibility of handing out $84 billion in the Recovery Act and the financial recession. I met once every 2 weeks with the inspectors general. Everything was over.
The kind of economy we need for the future.
You promised to buy Americans.
I was glad to work with the vice president in forming six separate task forces, which had some of the most knowledgeable people in the country coming together to deal with education and climate change and healthcare and the economy and criminal justice and immigration reform. And these folks, needless to say, people who represented the progressive movement had a different perspective on things than did Biden's people. But there was serious discussion and I think a real honest effort to come up with a compromise. And I think the compromise that they came up with, if implemented, will make Biden the most progressive president since FDR.
Look, I know I'm not going to be in the White House. I think some of my ideas are when we put Joseph Biden in the White House. And I'm just thrilled by that. And there's another concept, too, that I think shows his leadership capability. I mentioned this issue of unitedness. He really has united us. You know, Senator Sanders was involved in this. AOC has been involved. It's been a very uniting platform.
Arizona is very much in play in 2020. So we appreciate you taking some time to talk to the people of our state.
Oh, it's an important city. Irreversible steps we'll take to mitigate and adapt to climate change and put our nation on the road to net zero emissions no later than 2050.
You've said that you regret.